Hi viewers, this is Thirmal, Commerce faculty from Hyderabad. So in the previous video, I explained golden rules of accounting, personal account, real account and nominal account, right? So every transaction has two aspects, right? Every aspect is an account, right? One account is debited, another account is credited, right? So that is as per the rules of accounting. So in this video, I will be teaching you how to write debit and credit for the transactions. So with some examples, see this first transaction, Mr. X started business with cash with 10,000 rupees, right? So in this transaction, one person involved, Mr. X, and also cash involved. If the transaction includes any person, we have to follow the rule of personal account rule, right? So debit the receiver, credit the giver. So at the time of recording the transactions in the books of accounts, we must feel one thing. So the business organization is ours. We must assume the business organization is ours, right? So see this, cash comes in or goes out. Cash is an asset. So we have to follow the rule of real account. As per the rule of real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Here what comes in? Cash. Cash comes into the business from Mr. X, right? When asset comes into the business, that will be debited. Here what comes in? Cash. See this, cash account is to be debited with 10,000 rupees. That's it. Cash account is to be debited with 10,000 rupees because cash comes into the business. When cash comes into the business, that is to be debited as per the rule of real account. That's it. One account is debited. Automatically, another account has to be credited. What account has to be credited? See this, Mr. X, right? Mr. X started business. Mr. X is a person. So we have to follow the rule of personal account. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. See this, cash comes into the business from Mr. X. So automatically Mr. X is giving. Mr. X is giving. So Mr. X is a giver. Credit the giver. So Mr. X is a owner. So owner invested money is treated as capital. So that's why we have to write like this. Mr. X capital. Mr. X capital account is to be credited with rupees of 10,000. That's it. Cash account is to be debited with 10,000 rupees because cash comes in as per the rule of real account. Next, Mr. X capital account is to be credited because Mr. X is a giver, but he is an owner. That's why we have to write capital, right? Mr. X capital account is to be credited with 10,000 rupees. That's it. Next, coming to second transaction, see this. Purchased goods from Mahesh, rupees of 500. Purchased goods, it is one of the major expenses to every business. All expenses will be debited, right? So in this transaction also one person involved. Who is that? Mahesh. So then we have to follow the rule of personal account. Just we have to observe that person is a receiver or giver. If he is a receiver, that account is debited. If he is a giver, that account is credited. See this, purchased goods from Mahesh. So Mahesh is a giver because we are purchasing goods. So means Mahesh is giving goods. So credit the giver. So Mahesh account is to be credited. At the same time, purchase account is to be debited because all expenses will be debited as per the rule of nominal account. See this, purchases account is to be debited with the rupees of 500. That's it. One account is debited, automatically another account has to be credited. What is that? Mahesh account is to be credited with the rupees of 500. Purchase account is to be debited because all expenses will be debited as per the rule of nominal account. Next, Mahesh account is to be credited because Mahesh is a giver. Mahesh is giving goods to us. So that's why Mahesh account is to be credited. That's it. Next, coming to third transaction, sold goods to Naresh. Sold goods to Naresh. Rupees of 1000 rupees. Sold goods. It is a major income. Purchase of goods is a major expense to every business. At the same time, sale of goods is a major income to every business. So all incomes will be credited as per the rule of nominal account. What is that income here? Sales. So sales account is to be credited. So in this transaction, one person involved. Who is that? Naresh. So we sold goods to Naresh. So automatically Naresh is a receiver or giver as per the rule of personal account. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. So he is a receiver. So automatically Naresh account is to be debited, sales account is to be credited. See this. Naresh account is to be debited with rupees of 1000. Okay. Next, sales account is to be credited with the same amount, that is 1000. Naresh account is to be debited because Naresh is a receiver, right? Next, sales account is to be credited because sales is an income. That's it. Next, coming to fourth, that is a paid cash to Mahesh, right? So in this transaction, again one person involved. Who is that? Mahesh. So what rule we have to follow? We have to follow the rule of personal account. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. So he is a receiver or giver, that is what we have to identify. So we are paying cash to Mahesh, so automatically Mahesh is receiving, so he is a receiver. So Mahesh account is debited as per the rule of personal account. Next, cash is an asset. So what rule we have to follow? We have to follow the rule of real account. What comes in debit, what goes out credit. Here what means asset, whatever asset it may be comes into the business, that is to be debited. Whatever asset goes out, that is to be credited. Here we are paying cash, means cash goes out. So when cash goes out, that is to be credited, right? Cash account is to be credited because as per the rule of real account. Next, Mahesh account is debited because Mahesh is a receiver. See this. Mahesh account is to be debited with a rupees of 500. Next, cash account is to be credited with rupees of 500. That's it. Next, coming to fifth, received cash from Naresh, rupees of 1000. So we received cash from Naresh. So here one person is involved. Who is that? Naresh. So what rule we have to follow? We have to follow the rule of personal account. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. We received from Naresh. So automatically Naresh is a giver. So credit the giver. So Naresh account is to be credited. It's clear. Next, what he is giving? Cash. So he is giving cash. We are receiving cash. Means cash comes into the business. Cash is an asset. So we have to follow the rule of real account. What comes in debit? Here what comes in cash? Cash comes into the business. That's why cash account is to be debited with rupees of 1000. Next, cash account is debited because cash comes into the business. From where? From Naresh. Naresh is giving. So Naresh is a giver. So that's why Naresh account is to be credited with rupees of 1000. That's it. Next, coming to sixth transaction, paid cash into bank. So bank is a artificial person, either natural person or artificial person. We have to follow the rule of personal account. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. So here we paid cash into bank. So bank is a receiver. So debit the receiver, right? Next, cash. Cash is an asset. What rule we have to follow? We have to follow the rule of real account. What comes in debit, what goes out, credit. Here, cash goes out because we are paying. Cash goes out from our business to the bank. So bank is a receiver. That's why bank account is to be debited. Bank account is to be debited with rupees of 500. Next, cash account is to be credited with rupees of 500. Bank account is debited with 500 rupees because bank is a receiver as per the rule of personal account. Next, cash account is to be credited with 500 rupees because as per the rule of real account, what goes out? Here, what goes out? Cash. So cash goes out. That's why cash account is to be credited with 500 rupees. Right, next, coming to last, seventh one, purchased machinery. Purchased machinery. So machinery is a asset. So at the time of asset included in a transaction, we have to follow the rule of real account. What comes in debit, what goes out, credit. Here what comes in? Machinery. So machinery comes into the business. See this first. Machinery account is to be debited because asset comes into the business. That is a machinery, right? Purchased machinery, rupees of 1000 rupees. Example, machinery account is debited with a rupees of 1000. Next, machinery comes into the business, right? What goes out? What we have to pay? We have to pay cash to the supplier of machinery, right? Means cash goes out. Cash is also asset. So we have to follow the rule of real account. What comes in debit, what goes out, credit. Here what comes in? Machinery. So that's why machinery account is to be debited with 1000 rupees. Next, cash account. Here what goes out? Cash. Cash account is to be credited with rupees of 1000. That's it. So we have to write like this. Machinery account is to be debited because machinery comes in. Next, cash account is to be credited because cash goes out. Both are real accounts. Thank you.